In this section, we'll be looking at how to use Comsol to check the corrosion and the deposit for a cathode and an anode material. So we'll draw our geometry indicating for with both anode and cathode. We use this geometry, one side to represent the anode and another side to represent the cathode. And we are going to illustrate how the stress corrosion cracking will occur under the geometry. So at the end, we should be able to plot the local current density over a period of time. And also we should also see the stress corrosion cracking results for this model. So kindly follow to the end, and if there are any questions, please let me know. And please don't forget to subscribe and like the video for me. Thank you. When we move to our model wizard, we then select our space dimension, which will be 2D. Go ahead to electrochemistry, where we want to select corrosion secondary. So we go to corrosion deformed geometry, then we select secondary, corrosion secondary to our work. So we're going to add this physics to our work. This one will be using a secondary current distribution. Move to our steady, where we choose a time dependent with initialization, which brings us to our interface. So quickly go to our geometry where we add a rectangle. We want to add a rectangle, and we want to draw our rectangle 01. Same here. We want to choose the position as -0.01. Then we go ahead to build our geometry. We go on to add another rectangle to our work, where we also make here 0.01. Our height should be this plus 1 to our work. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So we just want to make a little change to the height and also to the position as well. We want to make a little change to the position as well. If you go on to build selected, as you can see, so we have built our geometry. Go ahead to booleans, and we want to make a union out of this. So we select both. Uncheck this. We want to join these two to make it one. Those selected, and they are joined together, as you can see in here. So we can see that we've joined our two rectangles together to form single unit. We can load our parameters from our work. We load parameters from file. We'll be using galvanic corrosion. Using galvanic corrosion. I'd like to search for galvanic. So these are parameters. We found it as galvanic corrosion with deformation, as you can see. We load our parameters. So after forming our geometry, we go on to add an electrode surface to our work. So we add an electrode surface where we select where this electrode surface will be. So we select 2 and 4 for our electrode surface. We check the species conservation. Check that. Let's open to check all these sections. Okay. Then we can now go to the electrode reaction. So temperature from the model inputs, the equilibrium potential, we put in this expression, but also our kinetic expression, we want to use a cathodic Tafel equation where we change our I not exchange current density to this. Change our anodic current density to this. Move forward. And we go on to add a second electrode surface. So the second electrode surface will be here, and go to the dissolving species where we add barrier. We want to name this as MG. Then this is rho MG. Go MG. So that's what we change in here. After we go to the electrode reaction, where we number of participating electrons, we make it 2. We set this to be 1. We set the equilibrium potential to be this. kinetic expression is, sorry, it's made of the anodic tafel, which will be I O underscore. And this is anodic, which will be E N as shown. Add a limiting current density, which we'll define as ILIM anodic, as shown, as we've done in here. So that's for the electrode reaction. So we want to check what we did earlier. I want to cross check and see if actually named everything as supposed to be. Our electrolytes itself, we go to electrolyte conductivity, where we make this user defined, and this has to be sigma as shown. Go to our multiphysics deformed geometry, check. Deformed geometry. So tense sets in here. Redometry, deformation also sets. Move to the non deforming boundary. For the initial, go to the second. Want to select only 5. So we want to select only 5 for this. So we want to select only 5 for the deforming electrode surface, and we want to, for the non-deforming boundary, will be the rest as shown here. So we go on to check insulation, everything sets. Then we can proceed to check our time that we want to set. We want to set our time from 0 to 12 times 3600, and we want to end at 3 times 24 3600 as shown. This could be very clear for us. So we can go ahead and compute our work. Which generates our results as shown in here. So we've been able to generate our results as shown in here. We want to add 1D